So, in this video, I want to show an analysis of a concrete test specimen under tension. So, and here we can see the specimen which I will model. And here is the real structure. Okay, now let's go to Abacus. Okay, we are now in the Abacus CAE user interface and we go to parts and then to solid extrusion. And then we will create a part. So, the total length is 200 and the width is 50 and the thickness is also 50. So we will use it like this. We have here the coordinates 25 and 100 and minus 25 and minus 100. And this is the main body. So the depth is 50. And then we will create some cutouts. Cutout extrude. This face here, this edge, and then we will create here some rectangles. And it is minus 50 and 13 and 50 and 50. And then 50 and minus 13. And minus 50 and minus 50. Okay. And then okay. And then we go to create fillet and select here the edges. Press shift and mouse. And then the radius is 12. And now we have here the test specimen. And now we need to create some planes. For example, here and here. Here and here, here and here also. Then here and here, and then we create here a plane in the middle, ZY, and one here, and XY plane 25, yes. Okay, then we create the partitions. Okay, it looks fine to me. Now to property module. Create elasticity elastic and the Young's modulus is here 37,000. This is 0.2. Then we go to plasticity, concrete damage plasticity. We use here those values. And then we go to tensile behavior and paste the plastic strain or cracking strain, it's for tension and the stress here. And then we go to tension damage and paste here the same, the cracking strain and then the damage parameter. And then we also need a density. Okay, and then we go to Section Manager, create solid homogeneous, and then assignment. Okay, and then we go to assembly. Okay, then we go to step. We use dynamic explicit. And we use here the status variable for element deletion and failure damage tension. And then we go to load and we fix here some stuff. So this is fixed and this is also fixed here. And then we apply here the loading. And then we have also to create an amplitude. Explicit 3D stress, but with reduced integration, and then here element deletion, yes, and now that's too much. That looks a bit okay. Maybe a little too few. Okay, and then we have to add a keyword, added keyword, and this has to come after the concrete tension damage. It's this keyword here. Concrete failure type strain. Then we have here the fracture strain for tension, the fracture strain for compression, which is zero. And then we have here the damage parameter for tension and the damage parameter for compression. We copy it and paste it here. Otherwise we won't have element deletion. Then we double check it because sometimes there will be added some lines without. Oh no, it looks so fine to me. Okay. And I think we can start now. Concrete tension. Okay, in the next part we look at the results. Okay, now let's check out the results. We have here our test specimen. Let's turn off the mesh. And let's look at the deformation behavior. So we have here fracture and we have here a relatively homogeneous stress state. Okay, so our yield stress or fracture stress for tension is about 2.8. Okay, now let's check how high is it here. Okay, now we have fracture, so about 2.7. That's fine enough. We could get closer to the actual fracture strain from the data if we would use here a finer increment for the loading. At the moment we have here 0.05, maybe if we use like this, then we would get a better value. Okay, but let's check out the stress strain curve. Let's take here an element. We look at the logarithmic strain and the stress in two direction, then edit here selection, select here one element and save. And then we go to operate on XY data and plot the strain versus the stress and plot. And then we can extract the diagram. And okay. So you see, until the fracture occurred, we have basically the same stress-strain behavior. But after fracture, it looks a little bit off. Okay, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching and until next time.